I am Nathan and this is Cambridge Autosound. Some of you may know me from my other channel, Cambridge Autogleam. That's obviously a detailing business. This is a audio installation company. Something I've been doing for as long as I can remember, really, like most people, starting with their first car. Out comes the head unit and in go a set of 6x9s on the parcel shelf. Obviously things have evolved a lot since then, and I've done other systems in the meantime. But last year I decided to go into it as a business. This is the first video on this channel. Obviously I'm new, I haven't got a massive amount of content to share, but hopefully you'll join me on this journey as the company and the channel grows. This is a 1984, I believe, 911 SC. And it's had quite an extensive upgrade for one of these cars. They're not the easiest car to put audio into. There's barely anywhere kind of behind panels to fit things, and obviously they were designed when speakers were smaller and not as sophisticated as they are now. So I'll show you around what I've done, give you a bit of a listen. There was a bit on the intro as well. Hopefully some of it's going to show up on the camera, but maybe listen with headphones on YouTube, because that's probably the best way to hear it. Let me show you around the car. First of all, we have got the Blaupunkt Bremen SQR46DAB. It's a classic looking head unit, but it has Bluetooth DAB. That's not actually then a cassette tape. You've got auxiliary input, USB and SD card. Not that people really use that. It's mainly just for your Bluetooth. But it's not a big shouty head unit. It sounds nice, but it fits in beautifully with the age of the car. Something not so age appropriate, although hopefully you'll agree that it fits in quite nicely in this car, is then the sub, a front sub in a 911. That's a custom built box. And first of all, so originally, I hope you can hear me, I'm just gonna turn this off altogether actually. There we go, I'll mute that. So originally in these cars that would have had, where's my finger? That would have had a center console that kind of went around the gear lever, went up halfway, and then kind of basically kind of follows that shape. And there was a couple of buttons on there, I think, for aircon, and it usually had a cassette tape holder on this front face for those people that used to use cassettes. That was removed on this car already when the customer dropped it off. It's got a Wevo short shifter fitted, because those that have driven these cars know that the gear lever is like stirring a bowl of porridge, and also when you're in fifth, it's really close to your knee. So the short shifter just makes it a nicer drive, and also then gives you a little bit more room for your leg. But with that removed, or with the Wevo fitted, should I say, that then meant that the center console had been deleted. So when this car turned up, it had the carpet on the tunnel with just some holes in it where the old center console was fitted. Didn't look that pretty. And we looked at it and thought, wow, that's a perfect place for a little shallow subwoofer. So it's a 10 litre box built out of MDF, laminated together. I've got some pictures that I'll overlay while I'm talking about it. It was templated in, built up. It's a Helix 10-inch K10S is their slimline sub in the box, bit of wadding. And it sounds really nice. It's it didn't need an awful lot of tuning. It doesn't go the lowest. It's not gonna kind of blow your hair around when you're sitting in the car. But for a 911, man, this sounds amazing. Yes, everyone that sat in it has kind of been blown away, and a lot, most people, because they're sitting on the driver's side, and on the driver's side, obviously you don't see the grip. All you see is haven't got the light on this side, but you've just got the trimmed vinyl on that side, and there is enough room for the clutch. We made sure that it actually overhangs slightly more on the passenger side, but there's room for and the customer sat in it and tried the clutch and he's happy. You do lose your footrest slightly, but again, compared to how this came in, most people just look in there, and I've got the light shining on it, so it's really standing out, but without the light on there, that just blends in beautifully to the interior. It's trimmed in the same blue as the rest of the car. So yeah, it doesn't play crazy low, but for a classic 911, that where you haven't got any room up on the parcel shelf to really build a subwoofer like you do in some later 911s, and there's very, very little room under the seat. That was the first place I thought about trying to add the slim sub, actually, but there's just not enough depth, and you'd have ended up having to raise the seat a little bit. So it's not going to work on every 911. In fact, it's probably not going to work on any other 911 unless you get rid of that center console. But it sounds great and it looks good. And if you turn the light off, it just kind of disappears into the interior. You don't even see it. But it adds an awful lot of depth to the sound, and it means that you don't have to push the door speakers quite so hard, because door application 6.5-inch speakers, yeah, they're 6.5s, the originals were 5s. But if you push those really low, you just get tons of rattle. They don't sound great. You don't get the same lows as this. So the doors are rolling off about, I play those down to about 50 hertz. The sub's coming in at 60 hertz. So there's a bit of a crossover. And the sub plays down to, you get down to about 35. So not crazy low. Those that kind of watch other audio channels and have competed in competitions, that's nowhere near the kind of mid-20s that people really aim for with some subs. But for a car like this, and just to give that kind of depth of sound and help the front speakers out, it sounds phenomenal. I had one of the guys from Audison over today, one of the reps, and he sat in it, and he was he wasn't disappointed. He wasn't giving me loads of pointers on things that could be changed. So really happy with how that's turned out. And for the rest of the car, we've got Audison Voce components. That's a 6.5 in a custom 3D printed baffle with a custom rain guard behind it, because the original one, like I say, was a 5-inch, and the Voce is quite a large speaker to try and fit in there, but it's actually mounted to the chassis of the door, not just to the door card, which I've seen in another 911 recently, and the speaker kind of wobbles about, and again, it doesn't sound the best. The Voce tweeter, they're kind of on axis to the driver, so that pod, these are again 3D printed and painted. That one is pointing more towards the driver. The other one is on more of an angle, so again, it's pointing a bit more towards the driver when the door's closed. Was looking at maybe trying to fit them on the dash, but the customer wasn't keen. He wanted them down on the door, so they're as far forwards as you can go on the door. And again, when the door's closed, you don't really notice them. Crossed over at a decent range, so that the sound stage is actually quite high. Again, the guy from Audison was quite surprised at how it sounded. Even though it's not a three-way system, the sound stage is nice and high, and you get the vocals right in the middle of the dash. In the back, we've got the Hertz. I think they're 4x, I can't remember the sizes now, but they're the Desi range of Hertz. I'll look up the specs. They're not 6x4s. Yeah, they're 6x4s instead of 6x9s. But they're a little oval shaped and they fit under the original grills, which unfortunately are cracked already. But at least they go under the original grills and they just blend in. And again, you don't really see those. But compared to the old ones, which again, I'll drop a picture of the old ones versus the new ones, the old ones were completely disintegrated on the foam surround. So that's it audio-wise, really. Yeah, Blaupunkt Bremen, Voce components, upfront sub Helix K10, and then the Hertz DCX460.3s on the parcel shelf. Oh, that's not it actually, because what you can't see then under that carpet, I'll get the light back out, although there's not an awful lot to see, but under the carpet in the footwell, on the back of the footplate, is a Audison Forza 8.9, so the AP F8.9, the more powerful Forza amp. There's some cable still visible up in there, because there's a tiny bit of a whistle on the speakers when the car's on. So I've got a couple of suppressors coming which need wiring into the power, so that's why I've left a bit of the cable exposed there, just because that's ready for the suppressors to go in. Hopefully that's gonna remove the slight whistle. It's only very slight when you've got it on mute. You can hear it just coming through the tweeters, but I'd rather get rid of it so that there's no issues and the customer doesn't have to come back. Had this car for quite a while. Customer's picking it up tomorrow. Like I say, he's been in a couple of times to hear it, and he's pretty happy with the transformation. Completely forgot to say as well, so we fitted this iPhone mount for the Apple wireless charging. Can't remember what Apple call it now, probably some wonderful name where they think they've come up with wireless charging, but that's all wired in, so you can pop your modern Apple phone on there, with, as long as it's got the Apple case as well, it magnetically sucks onto that surface and starts to charge straight away as well. There's a little USB cable just hidden up behind the dash, so that's a product from Design 911, the actual mount. It goes behind the clock that pops out, and then this is it's from Amazon, but I've tried four or five of these, ordered load, and this was the nicest looking one, and where the USB cable then comes from the back, so you don't really see it when you're sitting in the driver's seat. There's no wires dangling, so that's all in there as well, so we can jump in, pop his phone on there, charging it, use it for sat nav, and obviously stream into your Blaupunkt head unit. So that's it. That's a 1984 Carrera SC with now a very modern and a very good sounding sound system. If you're interested in something like this, I've got to do the a 964 and a 993 for the same customer coming up. He's into his classic Porsches. But if you've got a classic Porsche, drop us a line. We're fairly familiar with this platform now on what can and can't be done. And yeah, even if we can't manage to fit that front sub in, then there's a lot can be done with just the door speakers, maybe going three-way. Maybe pushing the door speakers a tiny bit more, but again, I don't know about taking them crazy low. But yeah, there's an awful lot that can be done to improve the sound on these cars, because a lot of them are running around with the original speakers still, and this is a huge upgrade. If you want to have a listen to it, let us know. The customer is relatively local. I'm sure we can borrow the car back and give a little demo. But otherwise, thanks for watching. Hopefully, I'll be able to bring you some more content. We've got a VW T5 in the room at the moment that's just getting finished, and yeah, hopefully there'll be some more cars coming along soon. I'm based in Cambridge, so if you're around this area, feel free to give me a call or drop in. Any requests, any projects you want to discuss, feel free to give me a call. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Yeah.
kick you out if she ever knew about all the you tell me that you do. Dirty, dirty boy, you know everyone is talking on the scene. I hear them whispering about the places that you've been and how you don't know how to keep your business clean. Bring a message to millions. They keep them going. I said, keep them going. Oh, don't take my fun. Keep them going.